Hi. Good afternoon, everybody. I'm Lior, the CEO and co-founder of Cybereason. I'm thrilled to be here. I would like to start with a customer story. It was a new CISO that just joined the company, and he was feeling that something wrong in the environment. He has a hunch. And basically, he called us and said, hey, let's start proof of concept. And shortly after we started the proof of concept, we managed to find that their environment is compromised. We managed to show them that 30 computers from 20,000 computers in the environment was compromised. And basically, the system managed to show them the full timeline of the attack, the root cause of the attack, and the type of communication that was conducted while the attack was happening in and out of the organization. And then we had a conversation with him, and he was wondering how come, while he had an excellent team, and he had an excellent team, and excellent solution installed over there, why they couldn't detect it. And I think that the answers from there was three things. First, the way we collect the information. So we have a unique way to collect the information by not disrupting the user, not disrupting the machine, and not disrupting the network traffic. On top of that, we send the information to our main server that can be on-prem or in the clouds. It's up to the customer to decide. And then we enhance the information from a threat feed from the outside of the organization. Then the analytic engines kick in and start to calculate it and basically connecting the dot between the abnormalities in the environment and the indication or traces of an attack. Then it generates evidence in our jargon, send the evidence to the decision engine. The decision engine evolves the evidence into suspicion, and the suspicion are evolved to what we call malicious operation or malop. But we didn't stop here. We created a new language to describe an attack to our customers. We call it five pillars of the attack. Basically, what is the root cause? What is the affected machine? What is the timeline of the attack? What is the tools that the hackers are using? And what type of communication in and out of the organization actually happening? And the very important part is to be able to present it in a coherent way to the level 1, 2, and 3 analysts to be able to understand the full story. We couldn't have done it with this team, phenomenal team that actually have expertise in hands-on cyber operation and a good team that understand how to create a product that can communicate in an easy manner to our customers a very sophisticated problem that we see today in the market. Thank you.
Good timing. Nice. Judges?
So if I have sandboxes in my environments, if I'm using sandbox technologies, do I still need this?
Good question. Excellent, actually. I think that sandbox is solving one specific problem, and it's supposed to stop the malicious software to enter into the environment. Our assumption is that no matter what we will do, somebody will manage to install something on the endpoint. And this is our assumption. So I think the short answer is yes, you need to have a sandbox, but with Cybereason, basically we'll be able to prevent it after something will happen.
Can you tell us more about the analytics? How do you actually identify when something is malicious?
So we use a combined approach. The first phase is to cross-correlate each, or basically to profile everything that's going on in the environment. For instance, if there is a process and there is a memory, we will cross and compare it across the whole environment. So we will be able to say, hey, in this specific machine, in memory, it's looked different than all the others, so we will manage to mark it, but we will not stop here. We'll just mark it as evidence and then try to evolve it to something else, basically to collect more evidence that this is really a malicious activity.
How does your endpoint solution actually see all this on the endpoint? And what are the security implications of that?
So basically, we're installing the solution on each and every one of the machine in the environment, collecting in real time constantly all the information event-based. Basically, we manage to collect huge amount of information and squeeze it and sending out over the wire between 5 and 10 mega per day across the day for one machine.
Do you actually see displacing any other products that the company might have already deployed? I mean, because we just keep layering and layering and layering, and I mean, is this actually going to remove one or two other things that might be on the system?
So our end goal will be to be able to provide a more holistic solution for cyber security, to be able to collect a lot of information and show you the full story of the attack. So I think that early days, it will take some time, but when the market will evolve, I think that we will be able to remove a lot of other solutions.
And can you comment on platform coverage, Lior?
Currently, we're supporting Windows, endpoint, and servers. In the very, very near future, we will support Mac, Linux, and in the end of the year, probably Android as well.
All right. Thanks a lot.
Thank you very much.
Appreciate it.